Hi guys, got a little project in mind, inspired by Jag Betty, or at least inspired by something I spotted in his SPIS HQ, a good old fashioned tissue cube shaped light shade. So I have a stock of coffee stirrers that I've built up over the years. Got quite a few of them, to be honest. And I need to make a cube with them. When I say a cube, it might be taller than width. That's the width. I reckon I can have four segments. Well, it depends very much on the size of this tissue paper when I open it. It says 75 centimetres by 50. Well, 75 is longer than this. 50. Right. But it's obviously going to be, that's going to be the width of my lampshade, something like that for the height. They're a little bit under 120. So I'm thinking of, well, I'm not really sure what I'm thinking yet. I'm thinking it through. If they're 120, in fact, 119, 119? What am I saying? 19 centimetres. Come on, Grandad. 19 centimetres width. If we call it 20 for easy maths, 4 times 20 is 80, and we've got 75 long. So I'm just thinking I could do all four panels and then fold it over. And I need 80, so we can't quite do it. But we've actually got 19, 38, 76, yeah, we're still about a centimetre over. But if I overlap them slightly, we should get four panels. Might be safest to actually lay that out and have a look at it. I'm going to clear the table a little bit more. I am tidying the table so that eventually we can get to it for Christmas. For a Christmas dinner. I'll tidy it a bit more first. There we are, as if by magic, half the table clear. I do know that this surface causes problems for some of my cameras, so we'll find out how we get on. That's the reason why it had the green cloth over it. We should be all right with natural light, but as soon as I turn the lights on, the flickering causes this to go all wild on the camera. So, back to plan A. We've got the tissue paper. So, it's that long. There's a front and a back. The back is less shiny than the front, so we'll work from, well, actually, which way do we want to work from? No, we want to work from the front. Because these will actually be on the outside. So my theory is, one, two, three, four. I will measure these later, but I'm just going to get an idea whether I've got enough of these. One, my maths must have been wrong, or it's slightly bigger than it says, because that I can get all four panels on there. All right, I suspect my maths was wrong. Can we be clever and do the top and bottom at the same time, or do them separately? I think I'll do them separately. I've no doubt there will be a YouTube video that shows you how to do this, but I haven't looked for it. That looks about right to me. I reckon if I just cut a line where it's already folded, that'll do. And then we'll organise these. Those will fit just like that. In fact, I think I might actually stick them on before I cut that. And we'll measure and do the middle. So we'll do the top and the bottom. We'll go for it. We'll see what happens. I'll try and get it done before we lose the daylight. Now, I've got this glue. I'm not sure how quickly it will dry or whether to go for prit stick stuff, the glue stick. I'll go and have a little look, see if I've got glue sticks. I think this might take too long to dry. It's clear glue pen, ideal for paper and cardboard. It's just the right stuff. Right, so I've got some Elmer's washable school glue and totem glue stick. This is an old one, this. That might do. So, plan is coat one side with glue stick. Place there. Not quite sure I'm going to do the folds. We'll find out. Same along the bottom edge. Might come in just a tiny bit. Of centimeters, just so I don't actually glue it directly to the table. Right, pencil. Pencil and ruler. So the gap between is 24, more or less. So that would be 8, 16, 24, yeah. Okay. So 8, 16. Now at the moment, I think this is the easy bit. Sorting out the top and bottom is going to be interesting. My plan is to use this as a solar lantern rather than proper mains powered. I'm not keen on, well, I don't know, I mean it might work as a mains powered one, but that's not my plan at the moment. bendy ones there. It is going to get too dark to finish this in natural lighting. That's annoying. Didn't start early enough. Oh gosh, that one was short. That was a short one. Must have been from somewhere else. About half an inch shorter, that one. Glad I spotted that. Otherwise it won't fold up. Didn't occur to me they might have been different sizes. Right. Oh, I fell on the floor. Can I just spin this round? So we can look at this. Because my plan is cross like that for the top and the bottom. Gonna have to find a few more of these. I would think if we go over, under, over, under, something like that. Probably ought to measure it to get it right. And we probably want a little bit of an overlap to glue onto there. In fact, if we have an overlap there as well, that'll make life easier. Yeah, should have left myself half an inch gap top and bottom so we can fold it over. I think it'll still work, but I've made it a bit more difficult for myself. So pencil, because people don't understand half an inch, better say a centimetre. Oh, your solar snowman's just lit up in the background there. Right, what did we say they were? They were 19, so we want 21. One centimetre. This is to allow for the overlap. Three's into 19, six and a bit. Yeah, I reckon that's just six in. Six in from there. Six in from there. Oh, got to go to the door. Right, answered the door. How far did I get? Right. I'm going this way. Right, here we go again. They're all the same length. I need a few more. They're all the same length. I was going to try and be clever, wasn't I? Over, under, over, under. Can't do that. Not glue it at the same time. So we'll just do all this way first. And then this way, it's going to be interesting. push it down, it should make contact with the tissue paper and pull the paper up. I haven't quite decided how I'm going to fit a light bulb in there. Well, I have an idea, if I can find what I've done with it. One of those solar lights. Yeah. Anyway, we'll leave that to dry for a few minutes. It is getting too dark to film, so I'm going to have to put the main lights on in a minute. But I've got the general idea. I'll cut them out. Cut along there, fold that up, stick them top and bottom, and it might work. Right, we have the light on now, so we got shadows. Probably haven't left it long enough to dry properly. We'll see if we can cut it out. Okay, that worked. Except my fingers a bit sticky. You need a sharp knife to cut tissue like this without it tearing. That seems to have worked. I'll just put them out of the way for now. Now, how are we going to do this? I'm right-handed, I can't do that. I'll give it a little overlap. Right, my plan is that bit of overlap on the end there, I'm going to glue to that. Can we do any sort of demonstration what I've got in mind? So I'm going to fold there, hold there, and that bit goes at that end. We lift it in the middle. I want that to fold in and glue that down the back of it. I'll have a think for a minute how I'm going to do that. Like that, so I can put some glue on it. This is probably where it's all going to go horribly wrong. Definitely don't want it to stick to the ruler. Or the table underneath. Got a little bit on the edge there, we don't want that. Come on, lay flat. Right, ready for this all to go horribly wrong? Lift that up in the middle there somewhere. Just to maintain a bit of a gap. Right, we'll hope that that's doing the job. Back in a minute. Well, I haven't really thought this through. I've got no idea how I'm going to hold it still while I try and put the top and bottom on it. I've got that, which I think might fit inside to hold things in place. See the general idea. So we've got a rough idea what's going on. Really haven't thought this through, have I? So we'll put that on the bottom. Position that just so it holds it still. And then somehow, or would it be easier to do the top first? Sit that on there. That might work. Cut the corners off so it will fold. Lay that on top there. I might do the other end. Take that out of the way. I don't know if that helps or not. I've got another idea. Lay that down flat. Put one edge on. Give me a start. Yeah, okay, that's what I think I'll do. If it all goes wrong, at least you'll be able to watch what I did wrong, won't you? So you won't make the same mistakes. Obviously, I need to cut holes out when we're finished. Thinking I can now put this on top of there and bring the other side up, maybe, but I might let that dry a bit first so it's got a bit more strength. So back in a minute. Right, had another idea. I've got this thing. So I'm going to stand that on there with that in it. You'll see what I mean. Up there. This is purely to help hold the top up so it doesn't just all flop over on me. So we've done that one. So we want to get some glue on that one. These will be harder to do, but that one should be all right. I think an extra pair of hands would be handy here. Well, I did get a layer on there anyway. So that's got to sit back there. We don't want to get any sticky stuff on our fingers. On there. Like I said, there's bound to be YouTube videos that show how to do this properly. Sticky fingers, that's not good. Sticky fingers is bad. Enough glue on there.
definitely a three-handed job. Not getting enough glue on there. If we put it on here instead. That looks good to me. If I lift that up and turn the whole thing over, rest it down on there, we can see the general idea. Bottom's going to be fun because I can't have the jar inside while I put the bottom on, or the top, whichever way round we want to call it. I don't think I needed that overlap. Right, back in a minute. Right, I've let it dry for a while. I'm tempted to cut this little extra bit off. I thought it would be useful, but I don't think it is. So, try and fit this. Cut those corners off again. might just pay me to make a hole in the middle there for where the light's gonna go in. I'll show you the light. This is the one I'm going to use, comes off of one of these solar lights. It's not going to be terribly bright, but I'm just going to sit it on top of there so that it lights up. We may change it later, but that's plan A. Okay, so we might just try and put the first side on again like we did last time and then struggle with the rest of it. Because obviously we've got to lift it off the vase next. No doubt if you were in production doing this, you'd have a proper framework that holds it open for you. And you'd probably make these inside, not outside. Okay, now for the fun. Now for the other three bits. Oh, I was going to make a hole in the top as well before I take it off. It doesn't need to be a big hole because it's only for the LED to go through. Do for now. If we're going to put a light bulb in there, then we'd need to open it up a bit more. That does mean I can put my finger in there to lift it up. That makes life a bit easier. But now we've got nothing to support it. I think I might try and put the glue on first. How can we do this? Put the glue on that one. Yeah, some sort of collapsible metal frame would be ideal for this, wouldn't it? So you can actually put it inside to all this, then collapse the metal frame and bring it all out. That bit doesn't want to sit. That just doesn't want to sit down. What I don't want to do is get my fingers sticky and then start it all ripping apart when I try and push it. Can I ease that out with the end of my ruler? Well, that's more or less it. I do need to, I know, just super glue a couple of bits of string to the top here to support it. Can we let that stand? How about on its side? Right. Bit of kite string, I think. Super glue, where have I hidden that? There's little gaps up there. Right, give that a few seconds to dry. Right, for now, as I say, we're just going to use this. Sit on top of there. So I'll rig this up somewhere where we can actually see it and turn the lights on and off. Hanging from one of my tripods in the kitchen, I'll switch the light off and we'll see what happens. Well, that works. It's not enough light to read from, but that throws quite a nice light. In fact, it looks better in real life than looking through the camera. But yeah, happy with that. Job done. Light coming back on again. There we go. Yeah, so 1, 2, 3, 4 times 4, 16, plus another 4 and another 4, 24 coffee stirrers, and a piece of tissue paper, and a solar light. Job done. Thanks for watching. If you want more information, check down below in the video description. If you like this video, you might like this one up here. And if you want to subscribe, you can check out my channel over here. Up here is my latest video on my channel, and down here is a video playlist associated with the video you've just watched. Thanks again for watching.